Good morning, my dear brothers and sisters. Together with our Cathedral Rector, Monsignor Rolando de la Cruz, we wish to welcome all of you once again in this Sunday Eucharist here at the Minor Basilica of the Immaculate Conception. Maligayang pagdating po at welcome home po sa inyong lahat. Palakpakan po natin ang bawat isa. Together with us in this Eucharistic celebration as well is Reverend Father Bong Guerrero from the Diocese of Cubao. Kasama niya po ang kanyang family. Father, welcome po. Our servers this morning came from, we have also visiting servers this morning from the St. John of the Cross Parish at Pembo, Makati. Mga kapatid, welcome po sa Manila Cathedral. My dear brothers and sisters, demands come in number. It could be a lot, or sometimes at least in tons for every individual. Just a sidetrack story. When I was still a seminary formator, more than the usual priestly duties that were asked of us, saying mass, hearing confessions, and the like, I was asked to teach 4 subjects: values education, Christian formation, intro to philo, and hindi man po halata sa aking expertise, pinagturo po ko ng computer. Ano pong alam ko doon? At least ICT for catechesis. The schedule of my classes would be from Monday until Thursday, from 8 to 10 in the morning, sometimes 10 to 12. On Saturdays, di pa po tapos ang kwento, I would attend my MA classes at San Beda from 9 to 12, 1 to 4. In between those days, we will be doing our seminary duties for our seminarians and our other ministries for the archdiocese. Loaded po ano? Hindi naman masyadong busy si Father noong mga araw na iyon. Friday lang po ang hinga ko, minsan wala pa. Kaya po, hindi uso sa akin ang TGIF. I know many or some of us would face the same load of demands or would have unending demands, be it with your company, be it with your family, your school, and with your respective spaces and communities. We saw this maybe and are seeing these demands picking up during the pandemic and even until now. The onset of online classes, tons of requirements, tons of performance tasks. Sa mga students, na-miss nyo bang marinig ang performance tasks? Baka meron pa kayong utang sa inyong mga teachers. Tons of virtual meetings, so on and so forth. And as these demands are going up the sky, the demand for rest seeks its peak as well. Dumadami ang trabaho, kaya ang kagustuhang magpahinga o tumigil kahit papano, napakataas din. And we cannot invalidate your feeling, our feeling of our need of respite. We look forward to vacation. We look forward to Fridays. We look forward for at least long hours of sleep, etc. and etc. Dear brothers and sisters, if there is a message that I wish to share with you today, let us be reminded of this fact. God would not only want you to rest with Him. Rest as in W-R-E-S-T. He also wants you to rest in Him. R-E-S-T. Just a context from what we have heard from our gospel this morning. Jesus prayed these words of our gospel today, consequent to the many success stories of His disciples, who would not be happy seeing your apostles gaining all the success and graces for the mission? Who would not be happy for your disciples' achievements? I do believe that when Jesus exclaimed, "I give praise to you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth," such is the experience of the disciples, wrestling the world with Jesus, wrestling the world with God. And the wrestling done inflicts no hate or harm. But with Jesus and with God, they were able to wrestle hearts difficult to move, to wrestle with faith difficult to shape, and wrestle with persons difficult to embrace. And that is why it is just fitting that after wrestling the world with God, it is just necessary that Jesus demanded them, "Come to me, all you who labor and are burdened, and I will give you rest." After the rest with God comes the rest in God. Alam ko po, you can figure out and even single out events, experiences, daily schedules, or even individuals whom we face with and wrestle with. Well, it could be your studies. It could be the demands of your work, the errands you almost face every day, the needs of your family, ang inyong mga bagay na pinag-iipunan at pinagpapahalagahan sa inyong mga kanya-kanyang tahanan. They come in blocks and even in multitude. You may have been eaten up by those demands. You may have been occupied with those and made you at least stiff and abnormal. You may have been restless with endless demands. But today, this God who sees and loves all of us demands this encounter with us. Hali kayo. Pahinga kayo sa akin. Learn from me, for I am meek and humble of heart. After the seeming endless wrestling, resting with God comes next. I do believe that your Sunday attendance here at the cathedral, Sunday Mass attendance here at the cathedral, or to wherever you are from, your Sunday is your rest day after wrestling the past week. And maybe after resting in God and with God this day, you will still face another week, another battle, another endless demands and realities to wrestle come the next days. Naka isang buwan pa lang po ako dito sa Intramuros. For 13 years, I was a Makati boy. Namamangha po ako sa setup ng Intramuros. And if you have the time later, sa mga bata, no, magyaya kayo ng tour sa inyong parents at sa inyong group. Pumunta po kayo sa paligid ng Intramuros. Pagmasdan po ninyo ang Intramuros at ang ganda ng Intramuros. Pero hindi ko naman po ibig magmasama ngayon. Pero po, ang mga nakapaligid po sa atin, demands po ito. Demand na mag-aral. Demand na magtrabaho ng mabuti. Demand na maging healthy. Demand na maging maayos na Pilipino. Demand na maging maayos na tao. Demand na maging mapanindigan sa minamahal nating bayan. And although the demands may be so high, they may be so visible, at parang masasabi mong nasa tabi mo lang at hindi ka naliligtas sa mga malalaking demands na ito, here comes the cathedral. Demandingly big enough to remind all of us that inside this cathedral, there is this God who would like to speak to you again and again. Come to me, all you who labor and are burdened, and find life burdensome, and I will give you rest. We may not live inside Intramuros, but we live around fascinating and numerous demands to wrestle with. But I do believe that amid wrestling with life's choices and realities, God stands at the center to be our rest and our comfort. Although Jesus commanded the disciples to do their tasks, He had demands as well for His disciples. He demanded them as well to rest in Him, to learn from Him, to find strength in Him. Nakakahiya naman kasi sa ating mga tao. Nakakahiya sa mga marahil kilala nating mga tao, mambubuhos na nga ng trabaho, may kakayanan pang magpabigat ng puso, may kakayanan pang magpabigat ng buhay, may tapang pang pabigatin ang puso ng bawat isa. Pero, ni pahinga, ni lakas, ni inspirasyon, at ni ginhawa, hindi maibigay-bigay. God offers this demand of staying next to Him so that we can rest, we can learn, we can rekindle our fire again and again. May we have this capacity and this heart as well, that all of us, people, may feel through us that we are an embodiment of peace and home. After wrestling the world with God, comes the rest in God. Demands of the world continues to peak, but God's invitation to rest in Him and learn from Him tops the priority. Our surroundings may drag us to unending demands, but God's unending peace will be there to strengthen us again and again, to make us alive again, to make us ready to see again goodness, and ready to see graces and life again and again.